We start with the name of Allah. All praise is due to Him. And we ask Allah Ta'ala to raise the rank of our Prophet Muhammad and to protect his nation from that which he fears for them. Dear brothers in Islam, know that the sin leaves a trace in the heart of the doer, as was narrated in the books of the hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us that when a believer commits a sin, then this sin would leave a black dot in his heart. If one repents from that sin, then his heart would be cleansed from it. However, if one commits more sins, then this black dot would expand until it covers all the heart. This is what is meant by the saying of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, Ayah 14 of Surah Al-Mutaffifun, Kalla bal rana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun. Dear brothers in Islam, do not stay away from repentance, even if the sin is committed time after another, because the sincere repentance from a sin clears the heart from it. We do not say that the repentance of one who commits a sin after having been repented of it is not accepted. At-Tirmidhi narrated the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, what means, the majority of the children of Adam would commit sins, and the lucky ones are the ones who repent from these sins after committing them. Dear brothers, prepare yourself for the day of judgment, the day in which the mountains will turn into dust and the oceans will be lit in a blaze and dry out. Remember that great day, the day when no soul shall be able to benefit another in the least, with the exception of the intercession that will take place by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the entire matter that day will be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the other hand, do not despair of Allah's mercy, even though your sins are numerous. Ayah 53 of Surah Az-Zumar means, O my slaves, who have transgressed against themselves by sinning, do not despair of the mercy of Allah, for Allah is the one who forgives the sins, and He is the most forgiving and most merciful. So do not say, Allah will not forgive my sins and will definitely torture me in the hereafter because of the enormity of my sins. Believing as such is forbidden in Islam. How would you know what Allah willed for you on the day of judgment? How would you ascertain that Allah Ta'ala will definitely torture you? The torture of Allah is so severe. However, Allah is also the most forgiving and most merciful. This, however, does not mean that you consistently commit the sins, relying on the mercy of Allah and feeling safe from the punishment of Allah without seeking repentance. On the other hand, one must not despair of the mercy of Allah and claim that Allah Ta'ala will definitely punish him for his sins. This is also sinful. Dear brothers in Islam, in order for one to be safe from these two sins, one has to be between these two extremes. When one commits a sin, one must be fearful of the punishment of Allah and at the same time be hopeful of the mercy of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Dear brothers, repent and have in your hearts the firm determination of not returning to those sins before you are taken away by death. Ayah 8 of Surah At-Tahrim means, O you who believed, return to Allah with sincere repentance so you may be forgiven by Allah and admitted into paradise that has flowing rivers. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow upon us that we will enter paradise without prayer or punishment, to save us from the torture in the grave and in the hereafter. Ameen.